A green agave plant with spiked leaves is labeled with a sign. Text, agavachii, shaw's agave, agave shaw. Text, science in action, shaw's agave.
We're here with shaw's agave, which is agave shawii subspecies shawii. It's a plant predominantly from Baja California, but it's still known from two native populations in the U.S. Now, one of those was recently fairly heavily obliterated by the construction of the border fence, and so it's really a plant of considerable concern here in the United States. I'm Sula Vanderplank, and I work for the Botanical Research Institute of Texas as a biodiversity explorer.
A woman with glasses and long hair wears a gray sweater and stands outdoors with a plant and cityscape in the background. Text, Sula Vanderplank, PhD, Biodiversity Explorer Brit.
Populations like this one here at Cabrillo National Monument are particularly important in understanding more about this species on the edge of its range. One of the things we're particularly concerned about, as you can see, is that although this plant is reproducing clonally extensively, we don't see seedlings. We're not seeing seedling recruitment, and we're not sure why. And so we've started a series of experiments to better understand the ecology of this taxon.
A researcher uses a swab to take samples from the bright yellow flowers on the agave plant.
In the core range of this species in Baja California, we often see quite widely spaced rosettes individually across the landscape and much higher seedling recruitment. And so one of the things we're trying to understand is here on the edge of the range to the north, why this difference in growth form? And is this difference a product of this species being on the edge of its range climatically? Or is there something more complicated with the ecology and perhaps the presence of pollinators or conditions for seedling recruitment?
The agave plant has clusters of yellow flowers with long stamens and curly petals, positioned at the tips of tall green stalks against a blue sky.
We know the agave occurs here. We know the bat occurs here. We don't know for sure that it's actually feeding on the shaw's agave. We think that it feeds on the shaw's agave in other parts of its range, further south down in Baja. My name is Drew Stokes. I am a wildlife biologist with the San Diego Natural History Museum, and I specialize in bat research.
A man with glasses, a beard, and a hat labeled the Nat wears a plaid shirt and stands outdoors with a blurred natural background. Text, Drew Stokes, wildlife biologist, the San Diego Natural History Museum.
What we do know for sure is the bats are mostly found in urban and suburban neighborhoods where people have planted landscape type agaves and cacti, so similar species to shaw's agave, but not necessarily shaw's agave. And so we think that for sure the bats are coming here to feed on those plants, but whether or not they're actually feeding on the native shaw's agave, we don't know. And so that's what we're trying to figure out.
A map of Baja California.
So we're going to start a series of experiments both with the populations here in the U.S. and populations in Baja California, comparing and contrasting what we see about the pollination biology, seed set, seedling recruitment, clonal propagation by the plants in the wild, and trying to better understand not just this taxon across its range, but also its sister species to the south.
Red banners on flagpoles wave in the wind with a statue and a body of water in the background under a blue sky. Text, nps.gov/cabr. Funding for this video was provided by CNMC, Cabrillo National Monument Conservancy. Logo, National Park Service. Credits, featuring Keith Lombardo, Sula Vanderplank, Drew Stokes, Andrew Smith, Adam Taylor. Special thanks to the San Diego Natural History Museum, executive producer Keith Lombardo, producer/director Chad Thompson of Monkey See Media, music Whimsy Groove Kevin McLeod, incompetech.com, licensed under Creative Commons, by Attribution 3.0.